if you don't have an expert in-house, the best way is to go with a product that's already developed, that's already optimized. That, in addition, these are so small that the power loops are very small. So by themselves, they generate a lot less noise. They radiate less. We have many modules, very high density of power. We're talking about 800 watts, you know, only 2 by 2 centimeter, basically, size. So less than an inch by an inch. So very, very high density of power that solves, you know, the problem of the engineers, right? They have very dense boards. You have to put a lot of power supplies on it, but it's not the main purpose of the board. The board is a big FPGA. It's a big digital processor, and you know the power needs to be stuck in a corner, not be in the middle. So that's where this becomes very, very interesting. Yeah. The progress that all the digital, the processors and SoCs and FPGAs, DSPs, etc., all this digital thing have made. the amount of computation they can do, it's just amazing how it has improved. But this goes at a cost, and the cost is you need to power this. You have to supply energy to them to perform this. And the challenge really is, how do you make everything stick on one board? And this, for this, that's why we developed this very high power density modules, DC-DC power modules, that you can just stick there, and they go together with the digital, but they don't need any extra work to put them in place. You just put them here, it works, and then you can concentrate on the digital, which is the heart of the product. So yeah, this is the biggest challenge really is, how do you accompany the scale of improvement of this all this digital power. What we are facing in general are customers that are specialists in their field, which is how they use the processors or the FPGAs. So what they expect from us is that we come with the power supply solution that they don't have to think about, and they are no experts, so they cannot afford to spend any time or to hire someone to do that. So they just expect us to give them a complete solution that has to be working by itself, and they don't have to develop anything. These power modules, these DC-DC power modules that are completely integrated, that there's no calculation to do to put them in place. They take very small space on the board, and they're already designed. There's nothing to do. They're already qualified. They will pass all the tests that are expected of them. And yeah, it's a big save of time, and it gives our customer the time to concentrate on what matters to them, which is really the end applications. And EMC is a big issue as well, in general, with power supplies. Power supply is a noisy thing. When you combine this with a high-speed digital, they will run into each other. They will create problems. There are a lot of challenges in developing these modules. The DC to DC controller itself that's used in it, of course, you have to realize that we use the same controllers that we also use for discrete implementations. So we have a large portfolio. We always make new developments. But then in a module, it's a slightly different story, because here we are really trying to get to the highest density possible. So in general, what we do is we increase the switching frequency to allow the use of smaller inductors. You have to imagine that in these modules, looking at a 7 by 7 millimeter modules, for example, this is a PMIC, so it's a multiple output module. You have 4 inductors in it. So it's a small QFN with 4 DC-DC and 4 inductors. It fits in a 7 by 7 millimeter QFN. It's just basically the size of one inductor that you normally use for a discrete implementation. Introduced recently a newer family of our very tiny, low voltage, low current modules. They're even fitting in 2 by 2 millimeter now with an inductor. We might use coreless inductors. We might use special epoxy or special magnetic material for the packaging. And that's where we see that we can make very very good progress. In packaging, we're also embedding the die inside the frame. It doesn't participate into the height of the component, So we can make very, very low profile components using tricks like this. So packaging is actually also a big part of a module. You would think it's mainly electronics or mainly magnetics, but no, it's combined. Yeah, you have to combine all these expertise.